Now, we need to add a fraction to a mixed number. But to add fractions, we need the denominators to be the same. Now, the lowest common multiple of 5 and 4 is 20. So, we can find equivalent fractions to 2/5 and 1/4, which have a denominator of 20. 5 times 4 is 20, 2 times 4 is 8, 4 times 5 is 20, and 1 times 5 is 5. So, we can rewrite our question. Instead of 2 and 2/5, we can write 2 and 8/20, because that's equivalent, and instead of adding 1/4, we can add 5/20. So now, we have two wholes, the denominator of our fraction stayed the same, and 8 plus 5 is 13. So that's 2 and 13/20 as our answer. Now we have 1/2 plus 1/5. So the lowest common multiple of 2 and 5 is 10. So we can find equivalent fractions to 1/2 and 1/5, which both have a denominator of 10. 2 times 5 is 10, 1 times 5 is 5, 5 times 2 is 10, and 1 times 2 is 2. So, instead of 1/2, we can write 1/5, because that's equivalent, and instead of adding 1/5, we can add 2/10. So, we have one whole, the denominator stays the same, and 5 plus 2 is 7. So that's 1/7 as our answer. So let's show fraction bars to see what we did here. We started with 2 2/5, and we were adding 1/4. We changed those 2/5 into 8/20, and the 1/4 into 5/20. So now that our fraction bars are split up into the same number of parts, into 20 parts or 20ths, we can put them together, and that gives us 2 wholes and 13/20 as our answer. Then we had 1/2, and we were adding 1/5. We changed the 1/2 into 5/10 and the 1/5 into 2/10, and because they both had the same denominator, we could add them together, and that gave us our answer, 1/7. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that was helpful. If you're a teacher or a parent, then please subscribe or go to keystage2maths.com to download resources for this lesson and many more. That's all for now. I'll see you in the next video.